Hey guys, hi and welcome to the video. In this video, I would be teaching you about web scraping using Node.js. We'll develop a very simple image hunter bot, which will basically capture all the images from any website that is mentioned. And it will save all the links on a, basically in a text file. We'll develop using Node.js. So let us get started. So for this tutorial, as you can see in the comments, and the code is on the GitHub, and the links are in the description, okay? So we need these two dependency, npm install Cherio and request, right? Let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to define my Cherio object. You can say require. And say Cherio. So the Cherio is defined now. Actually, let me just hide my terminal. Right, so we have more space. Okay, so const, then we'll define request because we need that. All right, we have the request. Now we need to define the file object fs. This is a built-in module. You don't need to do an npm install on that. After this, we need to create a write stream. So the way I create in Node.js, the write stream is basically as this. So I will create a variable. Create write stream, the name of the file. Encoding would be UTF-8, right? Let me zoom that a little bit. So that's my file object. Now let us define the request. And we'll make a request. The request would be on a URL. I would be using my university as this website because I love to do crazy thing on my university website. So I'm gonna use my university website right here. Right now it takes a function. Right now, basically here I need to define arguments inside that. So it's take error response and HTML. So now what I need to do is basically I need to write simple if statement, and I can say if not of error. And respond.status code is equal to 200. That means the response was successful. Right? Else, if something went wrong that I know, then there was an error. Console.log, and I would say, right, so that's pretty much it. Now let us see whether we are able to make the request. script.js, sure enough we have success. Let's move forward. Right, so I'm gonna write my code here. So the very first thing, this basically I need to define the Cherio object. We'll be using like jQuery like syntax. So let's define that money or dollar, right? Const dollar equals to Cherio.load, and we load the HTML that we have defined here in the function. Right, once we have the HTML content, now since I want to grab all the images from any website, so this could be done in a very easy way. I can simply say I can use the jQuery syntax. So I can say dollar grab all the image tags, right? When I iterate over that, and this will basically take it's a function, right? So it's gonna take index, right, and image or an element. It's a HTML DOM element, remember, right? So now here basically once we have for each stuff we need to get the image var image equals to, I'm gonna call the dollar symbol, we'll search on the image object that we have, right? And then we'll grab the attributes. So I'm gonna say headers and I'm gonna grab the source attribute. Then I'm gonna define my base URL, which is my University of Bridgeport. That's the domain name, right? Right. Now I'm gonna combine both of them. So I'm gonna say var links is equal to, I'm gonna say base URL plus the image. Right. Now once that is done, I can just say console.log and I can say links. Remember, we haven't saved the result so far. We'll just check whether the result is there. So this script should basically pop all the image URL from any website. So let us try it out. Okay, let me just come out right from the terminal. All right, so here I am. I'm gonna say node script.js and run that and wait. And here you can see all the links from the website. I can open pretty much anything and I can show you. Let me open that one, this one right here. So let me copy that, come here and prove it that it works. Oops, sorry, that one is not the one. Let's try some different one, like a JPEG one, you know. Let's try this one. Let me make sure my internet connection is working first. Just want to load my Google quickly because sometimes my internet is really very, very slow, you know. Let us try some JPEG image. Let's try a PNG. This should definitely work. Let's go here. Let's now type that URL. Your file was not found. All right, just give me one sec. Think I have done something. The reason it is because I forgot these. Let's see the website. Yep, it should be correct. So we have the base, we have the image. Okay, let's just run this quickly and then test it out. All right, so we have the images, right? Let's try some JPEG images, like maybe this one. Maybe I did not copy it correctly. I'm sure it works because I tested it everything before the video. Right. So here you can see it does work. It got all the images, right? So these are all the images that it found from the website, right? All the possible images that it could find basically. So basically I did not actually just select the entire stuff. Here you can see everything. So we are missing one step, that is we need to save this, right? Now it's easy, piece of cake, right? So we remember we created basically a write stream. So all we could have done is said basically. Write stream dot write will write the links and write stream dot write the new line. That's all. Now let's comment the print statement. Okay, we don't have that anymore. Now let me run that script. Now we should see all the outputs in a file called as imagelinks.txt. I'm gonna open that imagelinks.txt. That's not the one, maybe this one. Yep, yeah. So here you can see all the links from the website. I think there are 66 of them and all the images, right? You can also download it. You can do a request.get on all of these images and you can basically get the image. You can actually physically download the images, right? So something, I mean, this is not that part. I don't want to include it in this video, but you can, since it's a link, you can make a request, right? You can make a request on each link. You can get the binary data, save it as a file. You know, that's the idea. So hope you have enjoyed this small tutorials on Image Hunter using Node.js, right? So if you have enjoyed it, do let me know. I can create some more contents for you. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next video.